Hello, I'm JW, and metal consumer units, once again, a topic that simply won't die. And here we've got a metal consumer unit. It's that old one I took out of somewhere the other day. And if we have a look at the bottom of this, you can see the large hole here where the line and neutral cables entered from the supply. And there was a rubber grommet thing on there as well, so not a problem with that. And that's how it should be done, both of the cables going through the same hole. And of course that's should be how it's done all the time, but there are instances where people might think that's too difficult or it didn't have a large hole, so they took out a hole here and put the line through there, and took out the next hole and put the neutral through that one. And the problem in doing that is that because you've got a current passing through there, that's going to create a magnetic field. Normally if you've got the two wires in the same hole, the two magnetic fields would cancel each other out, so nothing actually is the result. But once you start putting it through different holes, of course, that's not going to happen. And what happens, or is supposed to happen, is that you actually create an electric current in the metal casing itself, and that can cause it to overheat. Now, eddy currents, as they're called, is a problem in things like transformers and other things, and that's generally why they have a core made out of many sections of metal or laminations rather than a solid piece of metal. So in theory, if you put current through here and it came out of here, some overheating would occur in the middle. So I thought what we'd actually do is to get some wire, put it through those holes and put various currents through and see if it actually does overheat or not. Now, I've never seen one of these overheating, and I have seen a few where they have put the wire through the two holes, so it'll be interesting to see if this does actually happen, and if it does, to just how bad it can get. So we'll do this outside, obviously, in case of fire and whatever, and let's go and set that up and see what happens. This is the test arrangement we've got here. So on the left we've got the wire coming in, that sort of dull yellowy coloured one goes through the clamp meter, so we can see what current is going through, and it connects onto the wire we've got going through that metal consumer unit, and you see the wire goes through the one hole and then just loops around and comes out of the other hole, and then also it will connect onto the other wire at the other side there. And for the temperature, just put that thermocouple there, so the probe is actually just placed directly in contact with the metal between the two wires there, or the two holes, and that will display the temperature in centigrade. So just moved in a bit closer there, and as you see, the clamp meter displaying zero, and the temperature currently is 10 Celsius, and we'll just connect up the power now and see what happens. Now initially we're just trying this with a current of just over 25 amps, so 25.4 or so there, and this would be a reasonable sort of load for a domestic type of consumer unit. Now the temperature certainly isn't changing at all, so if any effect is occurring, it's certainly going to be fairly small, so we'll leave this on for a few minutes and then see what the temperature is after that. Well, that current's been going through there for over 5 minutes now, and as you can see, the temperature is exactly what it was before, 10 Celsius, so that doesn't appear to do anything. So we'll disconnect the power on this one and alter the current settings and try again. Now this time I've changed the current settings, so we should get about 120 amps going through there. So again, we'll just connect up there and hopefully the current will be displayed. So there we go, it's about 119, 118 or so, and again we're starting at that same 10 Celsius temperature there. So once again, no apparent immediate change in the temperature there, so we'll leave this on again for a few minutes and then see what happens after that. Now just coming up to the 5 minute mark here, and you see the temperature has increased by 2 degrees there, just changed over to the 12 there, current about 117 amps still, but bearing in mind this is pretty much the maximum rating that you'd normally have on a domestic consumer unit. In fact, it's actually quite over that, because generally most properties only have a 100 amp supply. And to say this has now been on for well over 5 minutes and the temperature has increased by a whole 2 degrees centigrade, so really that's rather insignificant, and certainly doesn't represent any massive overheating or any kind of damage. And in the real world, of course, this is such a small increase that nobody would have even noticed that it was actually changed at all. So we'll disconnect there and cut off the power. Now the wires that go through those holes are 25 square millimetres, so more than capable of carrying that full current indefinitely. And just check the temperature of them there, and they're very slightly warm. There's certainly no real heating involved there. And of course that's exactly what you would expect. And certainly the actual consumer itself, again, there's pretty much no temperature change there whatsoever. So a fairly disappointing test there. Although the temperature did increase, it was only by literally 1 or 2 degrees, so pretty much nothing at all. So it certainly seems that this problem is not particularly evident on lower size supplies, such as up to 100 amps, and that's sort of typically what you would find in your average house. Nevertheless, the wires going through different holes does not comply with BS7671, and of course they should go through the same hole in all circumstances. But until next time, thanks for watching.